talking in my sleep at night, making myself crazy.
Out of my mind, out of my mind.
Wrote it down and read it out, hoping it would save me.
Too many times, too many times.
Don't pick up the phone. You know he's only calling 'cause he's drinking alone. Two, don't let him in. You have to kick him out again. Three, don't be his friend. You know you're gonna wake up in his bed in the morning. And if you're with him, you ain't getting over him. I got no rules, I count him.
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports. I'm Ernie Johnson. With me, oh, you know him, Shaquille O'Neal. You know this guy, too, Kenny the Jet Smith. And it is Clipper basketball tonight as the Los Angeles Clippers go up against the San Antonio Spurs. Well, for San Antonio, they'd love to crack the top 10 in the Western Conference standings, but right now, they're stuck in 11th. Still a step up from their showing in last year's regular season, though. And tonight, Danilo Gallinari takes the floor. Has the height of a power forward, the game of a small forward. Kenny, what does he give this team?
Scoring efficiency. You know, lots of threes, lots of free throws, lots of versatility.
Impressive skill level for his size. Can shoot from a standstill and put the ball on the floor.
That does it for us. Kevin Harlan with a call, and we will see y'all later.
Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
This is 2K Sports broadcasting from San Antonio as the Spurs take it to the hardwood here at the AT&T Center. This is Kevin Harlan joined by Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and on the sideline, David Aldridge.
Ladies and gentlemen,
looking at San Antonio, they took the win in their last game against Phoenix. And there wasn't much question as to how that game was going to turn out. They absolutely put the hammer down on them.
I just thought the defense was porous. Got any shot they wanted, really, for most of the evening.
I'll give them credit. Even though they were facing very little resistance, they refused to play down to the level of their competition.
And before we get going, let's hear from David Aldridge, John on the sideline. David?
Well, guys, DeMar DeRozan grew up in California, and he idolized Kobe Bryant. Now, DeRozan says, Kobe was my favorite player. I watched everything he did, practiced almost all his moves, and DeRozan has become a multiple-time All-Star. Kevin?
Well, D.A., you can see that influence. Great stuff. Thanks for the report. Smitty, tonight, something we don't get to see much of these days, two grinded-out half-court offenses.
Yeah, you know this word pace, Kevin. Everybody wants to have this pace where you get up more shots, analytics. But that's why I love the finals and the conference finals. Two teams, they know each other, and then at the end of the game, you got to execute. They know your plays, you know their tendencies. It comes down to old school basketball when you start to get to that fourth quarter, and especially game 6 and 7.
Excellent point. We've got a chance here to set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade.
Wow, you knew that DeRozan has that in him. Didn't think he'd pull it off in a game, though.
It's stolen by DeRozan. Ball going up court and finished off by DeRozan.
And we talk about this a lot. Turnovers leading to transition points.
I love the anticipation right there for the pick. Then he wastes no time getting up court.
And the shot is good.
And where's the help? Obviously, a missed rotation. Something they're going to want to patch up.
Only the first quarter. Guys are getting in a groove, but communication on the defense has to be better.
And he gets the bucket.
That's just too easy. DeMar getting the shot he wants and where he wants.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on DeMar DeRozan. That's his first foul.
That's something you hate. You're trying to come in with an aggressive mindset, and that early foul could take you right out of it.
And again, the Clippers turn it over. Spurs ball. Spurs have gotten their first three shots to go in for them to start off this game. That shot is off. The Clippers go the other way with it. Last time they met was in Los Angeles.
And the previous meeting was a win for them and a huge day for the bench. The reserves really stepped it up with their scoring.
Getting good production from the reserves on a daily basis is a key ingredient to any team's success. You know, that's another good play call. They are shooting 80% to start this game.
And here's Bradley from three. Sinks the triple. Bradley's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. And DeRozan, here we go. And it's the Clippers with the rebound. Outplayed in the previous game on their schedule, losing to the Raptors.
And unfortunately for them, they just ran into a hot shooting team and really had no answers.
Well, they still should have been more active on defense, giving those guys a run for their money.
And that one is good. DeRozan's got 10.
Oh, man, a hot start for him. He's hit five of his first seven.
There's the pass to Bradley. And, yep, finally drops after rolling around the rim.
And this is what Avery likes. It's where he feels most comfortable, the in-between area.
And finished off by DeRozan.
And he can do a lot more damage to the rim than that when he wants to.
Oh, you're right. And with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one. Kicks it to Harris. Pass to Gilgeous-Alexander. And here is Gortat. Bradley, no one around him. It's Cunningham with the rebound. Bradley against DeRozan. Pass to Gay. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by DeRozan.
And a moment here to look at some of the stats for Gay. He's putting up about 14 points a night, 7 rebounds, and 2 assists. And guys, he's making winning plays. It's as simple as that. Not a star player per se, but he makes his presence felt.
And the numbers, they back it up. Whether he can sustain this level of production, we don't know. But the arrow's pointing upward right now.
And the Clippers decide to take their first timeout here.
Doc Rivers, the coach of the year in 2000 with the Orlando Magic. A championship with the Boston Celtics in 2008. A great career as an NBA coach.
To see the numbers for Tobias Harris. 19th in free throw shooting, and he's right up there in the top 20 in scoring. Certainly a force to be reckoned with offensively.
And his shooting form at the line has been outstanding. Economical release, fully extends on the follow through. He can close games for you. To the inside. Here's Gilgeous-Alexander. And another shot, and it's good on the way in. Gilgeous Alexander's got his second bucket of the night.
Just an innate ability to rebound the basketball and then make the defense pay.
When he gets a few of those early, look out. It gets his blood pumping, and suddenly there's nobody who can hold him.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander following the score by DeMar DeRozan. And here's Bradley from three. And again, it's the Clippers from deep.
For a guy who's much more natural shooting the long two, Bradley's worked hard to increase his range.
DeRozan, that's good.
And it's coming easy for them right now. Five baskets in a row in the paint.
Passes it to Harris. And we're just over 3.5 minutes into the first quarter. Gilgeous Alexander, good.
This is where Tobias has really improved, keeping his eyes up, making plays for others.
DeRozan fouled on the shot and picks up 2 points, so one free throw coming up.
He's been making plays all quarter on a terrific hot streak, helping to build out this league. You look at the way DeRozan has improved since entering the league, vastly different player. Came in mostly as a driver and a dunker. Has become a complete shooting guard, and he's a fantastic leader on the offensive end as well.
One shot, gentlemen.
Steve, with DeRozan, you can see the changes and improvements in his game year to year.
Yes, his passing is the most recent skill that he worked on. His rebounding and defense also have seen significant improvement over his career. He's one of the top shooting guards in this league.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
It's good.
Well, we know he's been confident with the shot, a big reason why they're ahead in this game.
Bradley kicks to Gallinari. His three-pointer's off the mark. San Antonio leading by five. And DeRozan, here we go, makes it off the glass. DeRozan's got 23 points.
We will talk about feed the hot hand. That's what they're doing this quarter, which is why they've been able to maintain momentum.
Yeah, another nice bucket down low. They've really been able to work the ball into the post effectively here so far.
And there it is for him.
Yeah, that's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
The pass to Gortat. Inside. Bradley can't get it to go. And here's Aldridge. He'll bring it up for San Antonio. 7-point differential. And yes, it's good. He's got 27.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
DeRozan brings the double team. Here's Bradley, and DeRozan sends it back.
With that leaping ability of DeRozan, he can go get it. His marksmanship this quarter has been unbelievable, yet they still trail in this game.
And another basket for San Antonio.
He has great instincts on the offensive end. He's tough to contain.
Clippers trail by 9. It's stolen by DeRozan. And finished off by DeRozan.
And really focused on establishing dominance down low. And guys, it's working.
They have played physical. They have owned the paint. And they have built up a decent lead here in the first.
Los Angeles calls timeout. Well, last season, DeMar DeRozan, one of the handful of NBA players, Steve, who bravely spoke out about mental health and how it impacts them personally.
Yeah, had a great column in which he talked about his depression and anxiety. Never easy for a star athlete or anyone to be so frank about that kind of subject. It takes a lot of courage to do that, and DeRozan was rightfully applauded for his honesty.
We can. Let's get a quick check of our 2K leaderboard for a glimpse at one of the NBA's most elite groups. the top three-point shooting wingman in the league. Second, Rudy Gay. And, of course, Gallinari.
I mean, these guys are all constant threats on the perimeter. Shooting the three isn't all, though, that they do. But it sure is a lot of what they do.
When the three-point shot is working for one of these fellas, that's when the defense has to be worried, because any of them can get hot from behind the line. Avery Bradley, a 6'2 combo guard, not a bad ball handler, but he gets most of his shots by cutting without the ball.
First free throw is good. Well, and as they will tell you, Avery Bradley, one of the best cutters in the league. And you know what, Smitty? He cuts hard.
And a true professional. He sets a good example. His teammates see how he gets after it. And with his speed, tough to stay with him.
And so Bradley nails both of them.
Here you have the consummate pro. Rare to see Avery Bradley complain or give anything less than 100%.
The shot's good. And that's now 33 points for DeMar DeRozan.
And jumping out like this, man, you automatically start thinking blowout.
Double digits in the first quarter. The only thing they have to avoid is taking their foot off the gas.
And he recovers it. And the Clippers miss again.
And I'll tell you, the sooner this quarter can end, the happier he'll be. It's been tough making shots.
And guys, they've come out and established a rhythm. And also their play calling has been on point.
Well, the two go hand in hand. Matching your strategy to your personnel is key.
Well, there you go. One team operating on all cylinders at both ends. Steals, fast break buckets, and the other team in scramble mode.
Clippers trail by 15. And finished off by DeRozan.
The man is not timid. DeRozan's become one of the game's more prolific scorers, and he's showing it all tonight.
Kicks to Harris. They need this, and it's sent back by Aldridge. And DeRozan, here we go. And they call the foul, so a chance at the line for one more coming up.
And I need to see some more assertiveness out of these defenders.
And you watch Rudy Gay. When he's in rhythm, he can still help you out. Good athlete, good jump shooter, not an easy matchup for opponents.
Here's what San Antonio's going with right now. Pirtle, he's checked in for Aldridge. Davis Bertans comes in for Dante Cunningham. Bellinelli, he's checked in for Rudy Gay. And it's Mills in for Bryn Forbes. A free throw drop for DeRozan. And Smitty, discussing Gay, he seems better now at getting his points within the flow of that offense.
Experience gives you poise. It gives you a bigger view of the game. Gay's able to stay patient now and pick his spots.
Now here is Harris. He's coming off a 10-point game against Toronto, and plenty of contact on the shot. So two free throws coming up. And San Antonio called for the foul. He's getting his first free throw attempt of the night right now. No good on the free throw. Steve, Tobias Harris with plenty of stops in his young NBA career so far. You wouldn't guess it, though, from his talent level.
Year after year, he advances his offensive arsenal. He's become one of the most dangerous scorers in the game.
He hits the second from the line.
Slowly but surely, Harris continues to elevate his game. The shooting, the playmaking, the ability to make a difference.
Shots good by Mills.
and you can't help but pick their defense apart. They're completely in disarray.
Thornwell, the pass to Beverly. Harrell kicks to Beverly. Unloads from 13. They get the rebound, and that one drops for him.
Oh, easy put back. No one got a body on it.
And there's one thing you're trying to minimize. It's second chance opportunities. Poor defensive rebounding for them.
Yet another bucket in close. That's how he's earning his points today.
And here's Beverly. He brings it up for Los Angeles. Harris outside. And Patrick Mills gets that whistle that time. That's his first foul. Here's Beverly. Sweet little floater.
A shot that Beverly's developed. Once you have the floater, you don't always have to get to the rim.
San Antonio leading by 19. Here's Mills. His shot is good, making him a perfect 2-for-2 from the floor.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Myrtle with the double team. Harris outside. To the middle. Here's Marjanovic. And Marjanovic with the slam.
This is a guy who knows how to orchestrate an offense. Terrific lead pass.
DeRozan. And the shot goes down. DeRozan's got 46 points.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
Here's Harris. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. We're about halfway through the season, Smitty. At this point, how much can teams really improve?
I think if you have younger guys, you start to see those guys develop. Then also, if you have a lot of new guys, you see the chemistry start to form. And then a lot of times you can improve when you have guys coming back from injuries. A lot goes into a season. It's a roller coaster kind of effect. But it's good when you start to see teams put it together at the halfway point.
All about managing time, managing games, and injury.
You're so true.
And, Smitty, it's amazing. Since Popovich took over the Spurs, they've missed the playoffs only once, only one time under his tenure.
Yeah, in his first season, they won only 20 games. But then the big consolation prize, they got the number one overall pick, which became, guess who? Tim Duncan.
And so he makes both from the line. The Clippers testing out new digital offerings, things like visual enhancements to provide live information, different viewing angles, Smitty, to their fans.
You're right, Kevin. Something the league is looking at as well, providing different options with the software background in Clippers ownership. It makes sense they want to break new ground.
Here's Thornwell, following the score by Jakob Poeltl. Back to Beverly. Poeltl with the steal. In transition, here comes San Antonio. Bellinelli's got the ball. It's hauled in by Los Angeles.
I appreciate the attack mindset, but with the defense tracking him down, it was probably better to kick that one out.
Baseline jumper. No good on the shot. A bit long that time.
Lazy defense against a good score. Turns out not to matter.
And he could not get that one to go. A lot of contact, and he'll go to the line for two. It's going to be on Montrezl Harrell. And Marco Bellinelli, a player who has always been able to light it up from outside.
And Belly has been on so many teams in his career, but is always a wanted commodity due to his shooting. Very quick and easy way to add outside shooting to a team. He can honestly play a long time just on how badly teams need shooting in our league.
And that one falls for Bellinelli. Both free throws good from Bellinelli.
This is strange. Last season, the Spurs finished out of the top 10 in field goal percentage for the first time in a decade.
Now here is Harris. He's got five. Beverly wide open. Good on the triple. Beverly's got five now.
Very consistent from long distance. Beverly a floor spacer offensively.
And Steve, when you think about the Spurs, you think great passing and total efficiency.
The talent level dropped for various reasons, and the ball movement wasn't as crisp. Makes it harder to put the ball in the cylinder.
LA has gone 3-of-4 on three-pointers in the first quarter, doing well from long range. Harris inside the line. San Antonio with the rebound. A minute 20 left to play in the first. Off with the layup. Here's Thornwell. White covering. And it's Beverly missing. San Antonio leading by 22. Shots good by Mills. 6 points for him.
Oh, this is the kind of start they were hoping for.
Here's Marjanovic, and he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. It's his first trip to the line.
An 80% shooter, the work he's done at the line this season, one word, solid.
And he knocks down the first one. Los Angeles making a switch here. Scott's checked in. And good on the second, so he makes them both. Well, the Clippers looking to build their own arena in Los Angeles. Being the second or third tenant at Staples Center doesn't really feel right anymore.
Big plans are laid in Inglewood, adjacent to the new football stadium. Seems like it would be a win for the fans, the team, and the city.
And here is Los Angeles now, after the basket by San Antonio. Beverly finds Harris. And Pirtle pulls it down.
Obviously, this has been a tough quarter for him, but he's still trying to keep a positive mindset.
Shots good by Mills.
Just increasing their advantage, and right now they're in a zone on both ends.
Yeah, this lead has snowballed. Credit their killer instinct for piling on.
Now, here's Beverly. 5 points in the game. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Clock at six. Here's Harris. The shot, no good. And here's Mills for three. He knocks it down right at the buzzer.
That's a shot he'll never forget. Oh. As dramatic as they come.
A thrilling way to finish this one.
And so it's DeMar DeRozan making highlights for the San Antonio Spurs. With the points he racked up that quarter, he has broken his season-high scoring mark already. Back to the action after this word. And welcome back to the second quarter of action. Plenty of basketball left to play, but this one has been one-sided so far. And guys, we've seen a confident-looking Spurs team out there.
I tell you, on fire all period long. And this is how you want to start the game.
They build up a monster lead on the heels of great shooting. Love the attack mindset here.
And here's Beverly. He brings it up for Los Angeles. Taking a look at Los Angeles. They've got Marjanovic. Thornwell is out there with Patrick Beverly. Then it's Mike Scott. And it's Harris in at the three slot. It's deflected.
Gotta love the shot blocking ability of Pirtle. Wonderful timing right there.
Berton's shot is good.
And of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is just smash mouth physical basketball, guys.
Scott. No good from outside. And the Spurs with possession. Here's White. Bellinelli trying to break loose. White, good.
I'm sorry, that's poor defense down low again. It's been a mismatch thus far in the paint.
Now here's Beverly, covered by Mills. Thornwell can't get it to go.
When you miss a lay-in, it sort of sucks the energy out of your team.
Here's Pirtle. Whistle blows, bucket is good, and he'll have a chance at the line to make it a three-point play.
Super focused. Pirtle taking the hit well and cashing in on a quality and one opportunity. Pirtle, taken ninth overall in the 2016 draft, has a great presence in the middle of the paint and can trade blows with the other big men across the league.
The Spurs making a switch here. Gay's checked in. Gallinari, he's checked in for Los Angeles.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
And the free throw, no good. And Pirtle last season, Steve, earning more playing time.
He fought his way into being a rotation player, showed good grit, and was a solid contributor off the bench.
And that one's good. Beverly.
That's what they expect from Patrick Beverly, knocking down the spot-up J.
Spurs have gone a nice 3-3 to start the second. Here's Gay and the jam by Rudy Gay.
And no doubt they've been the more efficient team in this first half.
Because they've been patient, they're finding good shots. That's why they've hit a much higher percentage from the floor.
Los Angeles has gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. And stolen by Gay. And the whistle blows on the backcourt violation. He went over and back.
Not a problem. First turnover of the game, but overall, I like how they're taking care of the basketball.
For the Clippers, Gortat has come in for Marjanovic. And it's Avery Bradley in for Sendarius Thornwell. And stolen by White. Here's Bellinelli. Here's Gay. That one goes. Count it. Gay's got 4 points this quarter.
It's a plus five advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Here's Gallinari. Bellinelli pulls it in. Bellinelli's got 4 rebounds now tonight. And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, the Clippers have hit the reset button, and you wonder how that affects their head coach, Doc Rivers. Now, he seemed reluctant to lead a rebuild with the Celtics, but he's on board doing it with the Clippers. Even though the Clippers relieved him of his title of president of basketball operations in 2017, Rivers has just signed a new extension that will keep him coaching the team for the next few years. Kevin?
Well, if nothing else, DA, he has guided them through some pretty dark hours. Thank you. Scott can't get it to go.
How does he miss that layup? He's too good to be doing that.
Drops in the layup for two.
And not hard to see why they are giving up points on this run. Just too many good looks from in close.
Beverly, the pass to Gortat. The three from Bradley. The putback and the second chance ever by Gortat.
Time out.
Gortat's got his first bucket in this one.
And that's a pure hustle play, getting to the offensive glass for the tip-in.
And that's the kind of quality you see in any strong offensive rebounder, isn't it? And San Antonio calls the first timeout of the game. And Marcin Gortat, the Polish hammer, in the final year of a 5-year, $60 million deal. Greg, he's been worth every penny.
He has, but he turns 35 this season. He'll be motivated to earn that next contract, but now on the downslope, we may see his role evolve over the next few years.
Some changes here for the Spurs. LaMarcus Aldridge, he's checked in for Pirtle. Cunningham comes in for Davis Bertans. And it's Bryn Forbes in for Bellinelli.
And the Clippers with a change here, too. Gilgeous Alexander's checked in for Patrick Beverley. And the foul on Avery Bradley. And that'll be his third foul so far.
Man, it's close, but, you know, didn't get on balance quick enough.
Down low, Aldridge. Yep, it counts.
That's their third straight make off an assist.
Los Angeles has gone 4 of 8 tonight from three-point land, shooting 50% on the three ball here.
Leaving no doubt about that one. Gallinari active, getting to the rim.
Here's Aldridge. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up. That's on Marcin Gortat.
A five-star recruit out of high school. Aldridge reportedly asked Shaq for advice about jumping to the NBA. Shaq told him to go to college. A couple years later, Aldridge is drafted the number two pick overall.
Two shots.
And that one falls for LaMarcus Aldridge. And regarding Aldridge, given his success at Texas, sounds like Shaq was right.
Aldridge just needed to develop strength, polish his skills. Hard to say where he would have been drafted right out of high school, but after 2 years of college, he went second.
Both free throws good from Aldridge.
Decent when he entered the league. Aldridge has turned himself into a phenomenal free throw shooter.
Pass to Gallinari. And here in the second quarter of action, as we approach 4 minutes played, feeds it to Gortat. And it's Gortat finishing it off.
He is a big guy, and Gortat doesn't play the finesse game. This is a guy who's all about strength. Forget about laying it up there. He's going to take the power approach.
And there's Gay. That's good on the assist by Aldridge. 6 points for Gay.
Another bucket down low. They've been the aggressors, taking the ball inside and attacking at the rim.
And it's Gallinari missing.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
Count the basket. That's now 8 points for Gay.
It's amazing. He is on fire here in the second period after going scoreless in the first.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander. 6 points for him.
And not a night he's going to want to remember. Just not really able to score the basketball.
Here's Cunningham and the Spurs scoring again.
And the jump shot has been a dimension of this game where they've had a clear advantage.
Inside and finished off by Scott.
A little undersized at the four, but he can get off the ground.
On offense, here are the Spurs. Goes up the baseline. The rebound by Gortat.
Can't convert, but a good opportunity from mid-range. He'll take that every time.
Pass to Gallinari. This one for three. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Gallinari's got his third basket of the night right there.
No surprise, throughout his career, about half of Gallinari's shots have been from three.
Dropping dimes all night. He's been completely locked in.
Unselfish basketball, that'll make you very popular amongst your teammates.
To the paint. A great 1-2 punch, beautiful pass, and nasty jam.
And he just elevates and powers in the one-hander.
Mm-hmm. Textbook. Here's Gay. The shot from the low post is good. Gay's got 12 now in this quarter. Los Angeles has gone 2 of 4 from three-point range so far in the second quarter. And the jam by Rudy Gay.
This is something Gay does wonderfully. An insane dunker who loves finishing strong at the rim.
Los Angeles has gone 5 of 9 when they put up the three-point shot tonight. Here's Gallinari, and there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
And really a good job spotting his teammate near the bucket and then just pinpoint passing for the finish.
Aldridge, and it's San Antonio with another. And Los Angeles guys shooting 44% from the floor since we began the second quarter. Nice. And it's Scott with the jam.
Straight rim rocker.
It looked like a Greg for a second, like he might rip the cylinder loose.
Well, what did Coach tell us? He wanted each guy to contest shots and rebound tonight. That's exactly what we just saw.
Outside Brantley. The 19-foot shot, and it's off the back rim, no good.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat. And they are attacking the rim and getting great results.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander, following the basket by LaMarcus Aldridge. DeMar DeRozan, he's checked in for San Antonio. And the Clippers making a change here as well. Montrezl Harrell, he's checked in for Scott. Harrell kicks to Gortat. Some nice ball movement by the Clippers. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. 14 points for Avery Bradley.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
The Clippers, they signed Doc Rivers to an extension this summer. With all the roster changes, good to have that stability on the sideline.
Aldridge against Gortat. From the stripe. Aldridge, no luck. Steve Doc Rivers, easily the winningest coach in Clippers franchise history.
He's also second among current head coaches in overall wins. One of only a handful who have led a team to an NBA title.
And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. It's going to be on Avery Bradley.
The crafty vet, Aldridge, positioning himself well to score, get fouled, or both.
This is his second trip to the free throw line.
Two shots.
He misses the free throw. More and more teams are emphasizing the transition game, Steve. What do you think it takes to be successful at that?
No, I think it comes down in a transition game if you have players, not just the point guard or the guy assigned to handling the basketball the most. When you have a lot of unselfish players, and what I mean by that is not a lot of guys can pass. You'd love to have that, Kevin. But also guys that will run and understand they won't get the bucket, but because they run and take a defender, that they allow a driving lane for their teammate to be able to score.
Steve, when we talk about signature shots in the NBA, what about Aldridge's fadeaway jumper?
Usually starts with him backing down the defender. He turns, faces up, transfers weight from all the way forward to all the way back. Add in the high release point, virtually unblockable.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander following the bucket by the Spurs. Now the feed to Harris. Fires from 18. DeRozan with the rebound.
Plus 8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Time called here. The Spurs decide to talk it over. Well, obviously a down season last year for the Spurs, but one of their best years in decades on the offensive glass.
No more for their defensive rebounding. The Spurs were 6th in the league in offensive boards. Part of that was trying to find new ways to generate points.
And Darius Thornwell's checked in for Bradley.
And looking now at some numbers for Danilo Gallinari. What a run he's been on over the past few weeks. averaging about 19 points, 7 rebounds, and 2 assists. And I'm not sure he can play any better than he has. I mean, surprising a lot of people with his play here of late.
Therein lies the question. Has he reached a new level in his game, or is this just a hot streak that'll eventually cool down? We'll see.
Fantastic ball movement. They're picking them apart with their passing.
Los Angeles has gone 2 of 4 from three-point range so far in the second quarter. It's going to be out of bounds. Los Angeles will retain possession. Marjanovic checked in for Los Angeles. San Antonio on defense. And it's Harrell missing. Here's DeRozan. Second chance shot. And you know that's going to be goaltending, guys. So that's a free basket right there.
Man, that's a tough call for the refs to make there. I'm not sure it was on the way down, but that's how they saw it.
Los Angeles has gone 5 of 9 when they put up the three-point shot tonight. Passes it to Harris. Gets an open look and hits. Harris has got 7.
Difficult to stop inside. Harris with the excellent feel and touch around the basket.
DeRozan with it. Picked up by Harris. And good! There's another.
My goodness. 50 for the game.
Yep, he is putting on a show. The pass to Thornwell. From 12 feet out, DeMar DeRozan grabs the board. DeRozan's got 4 rebounds in this game. Puts it up from 7. He got it again! Sensational!
And he's up to 52 points.
Yeah, making a GA look all too easy right now. Here's Gilgeous-Alexander, covered by Mills. And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time, the whistle blowing. And Smitty, the three-point shot last season, not the Spurs' best friend.
They rarely shoot a ton of threes, but the ones they take, they usually make at a high clip. They had a new starting point guard, and Kawhi Leonard only played 9 games. That won't help.
And the first one drops. Smitty, with all the different arenas you've played in and all the cities you've traveled to as a player, which city do you think, looking back, was the hardest to play in for whatever reason?
This is an easy question. Detroit, Michigan, Kevin, because I was raised there and played college basketball. The ticket request going home was definitely hard.
I bet.
Because now you're starting to ask teammates, you're starting to ask everybody for tickets, and I just never had enough.
And it was expensive to buy tickets.
Yes, indeed.
And everyone wanted one.
Everybody. My first game, Kevin, ever back in Detroit, 300 tickets.
Oh.
Glad I had good teammates, though. They helped me.
Oh, reversed it home. That was pretty.
Agreed. The agility on display. And so Beverly will bring it up for the Clippers. And slam dunk by Harris.
I love the patience Beverly has developed with the ball in his hands. Terrific find.
And Mills kicks to Bertans. DeRozan dishes to Pirtle. DeMar DeRozan again. DeRozan's got 58.
Yeah, you see the killer instinct. He's going for the death blow.
True story. They've got a monster lead that's taken a life of its own.
Now, here's Beverly. He's got 8. Pass to Harrell. To the middle. On the wing, Harris. Offensive rebound. Marjanovic, no good.
Yeah, and they've shown effort and aggression in the paint, really, right from the tip. Their rebounding edge right now, massive.
Thornwell kicks to Beverly. Pass to Harris. Three-pointer. Drills the three-pointer. Harris has got 12 points in the game.
Not a high-percentage long-range shooter, but Tobias Harris knocked that one down.
Here's DeRozan, and good, he hits it again. 60 points. This guy cannot be stopped.
They've had no answer for him in this one.
That instant replay brought to you by Under Armour Hover Havoc, giving us a chance to relive the unleashing of chaos that time.
The defense has tried to make adjustments, but Tobias is smart. He's adjusting back.
Mills can't hit.
Rough start to this game. Hits one bucket in the first and nothing here in the second.
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Now here's Beverly, covered by Mills. And Beverly kicks to Marjanovic. Shoots over Pirtle. Again, Los Angeles.
Marjanovic.
And here's Mills. So as we conclude the first half, so far fairly one-sided. It's the Spurs running away with it. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks a lot. Rudy, it looked like you guys found your old identity in the first half tonight.
Yeah, that's the way we played last season. Our defense was our staple. And that's all we have to do. We have to go out here and play defense every night. And this is a good start for us.
Let's see if you can stay true to yourself in the second half. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello. You're watching the NBA Halftime Show on 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson here at this beautiful table. This is a beautiful, beautiful table.
What is this, oak?
I think it's teak.
Oh, teak.
There's Shaq. There's Kenny.
It's polished oak.
Teak. It's polished very nice. Teak. It's very nice.
You mean antique?
No, it's just teak.
Teak.
I have an antique.
DeMar DeRozan brought his A game early tonight. He went on an historic scoring frenzy, tallying a ridiculous number of points, 5 steals, and 1 block. Kenny, what was your take on San Antonio?
Well, we can't look past the huge contribution their bench has provided. They've got this lead mainly because of the injection of energy and offense that they got from their reserves. That's what a coach wants to see. I'm guessing the minutes will be spread out a little bit in the second half.
Shaq, what was your takeaway on the Clippers?
Well, they got to do a better job on the glass. Ernie, they got outworked. They were weak physically. That's part of how they fell behind in this game. I think if they can control those things, they'll be okay, Ernie.
Thanks for joining us, folks. We're now just a few minutes away from the start of the third quarter.
And there wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. A fantastic game from DeMar DeRozan so far.
And the defense was soft in that first half, and he took advantage every chance he could. And boy, was he throwing it down hard.
I'm sure the D will improve from this point on, and because of that, he needs to up the ante in his attacks to the rim, too.
Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. DeRozan and Gay, the wing. Aldridge out there with Cunningham, and it's Forbes in at the point guard. So that's who Greg Popovich starts the second half with.
He's in control when it matters, giving them a tremendous advantage right here.
Here's Gallinari, and he finishes nicely on the layup. Gallinari's got 13.
Against physical D, Gallinari with the improved strength and body control to finish.
DeRozan, that's good.
He just said, hey, put the team on my back, and I'm going to take you the rest of the way.
Down low, here's Bradley, and the layup is good after a nice lead pass. He's got 16.
And that's how you want to come out of the locker room. He is fired up.
Yes, in the first minute or so, you knock down a couple of shots. You are in rhythm.
He gets a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, guys, the Clippers are going in a new direction. Now, Coach Doc Rivers said, we had a shot. I don't think anybody understands how hard it is to win a title. Until you do that, you're going to be frustrated a lot and have to make tough decisions. Kevin?
Well, they're trying to make the right decisions to rebuild better than before, D.A. Thanks. That's good from DeMar DeRozan. Well, Steve, when it comes down to how this country is developing young players at the amateur level, do you feel winning is overemphasized in relation to individual skill development?
Yeah, I mean, great question, Kevin. I think in youth basketball right now, youth sports, I think so much now is individually rating individual players that are playing a team sports. I want to see more of rating the team. And I think also guys getting a chance to understand winning is important. A lot of these tournaments, you play three or four games a day, and it's not so much about winning. I think it has to come down to win or go home. I love that for youth basketball. And then I also love that just getting better. And I would love for some of these youth coaches to move these players around. There's a player right now that might be playing the center spot, but let him try to play the guard spot. I think you got to find a way to do that and talk about winning as a team versus individuals.
Smart stuff. And good, he hits it again.
He is simply unconscious here tonight. Nobody can stop him right now.
GA, the points keep coming, and he's climbing up that scoring ladder. Third on the list, well in sight.
And his scoring tonight has dropped him into the conversation with some of the all-time greats. I'm talking about names like Wilt Chamberlain and Kobe Bryant. Simply amazing what we've seen here.
And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
Elbow, two.
For Los Angeles, they have gone 9 of 10 from the line, so making the most of their chances.
Two shots.
Shooting two.
The first one falls, and the Clippers, it looks like, looking to create a culture change, a team whose chemistry makes it more than the sum of its parts.
You know, you can have all the talent in the world, but it's hard to win if people aren't pulling in the same direction. They want to create the right environment and then find players who fit.
Both good from the line that time. Second half of play with just under 2.5 minutes gone. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. It's going to be on Avery Bradley.
So tough to guard. DeRozan with the strength, the near 40-inch vertical, and he loves to challenge you.
Taking two shots.
This will make four trips to the line so far in the game.
And with an 86% free throw average, you can count on him to come through on most trips.
And he knocks down the first one. Both good from the line that time. Not quite 2.5 minutes played here in the second half. Rebounded by the Spurs. Aldridge has got 8 rebounds in this game. And DeRozan, here we go. And he makes that one. DeRozan's got 17 points here in the second half.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
DeRozan brings the double team, and the whistle blows. It's going to be on DeMar DeRozan. And that'll be his third foul so far. Here's Gilgeous-Alexander. He's got 8. A 3 from Bradley. It's rebounded by Aldridge. Aldridge has got 9 rebounds now tonight. Baseline. Good. That's another bucket.
And that score moving him clear into third all time for scoring in a game.
Well, GA, you just knew it was a matter of time the way he's been playing. I'm sure he's not finished either.
He surpassed Wilt Chamberlain's less famous scoring mark from 1961, and Kobe Bryant now in his sights.
Here's Bradley, accurate with a jumper from the elbow. Bradley's got 9 points in the quarter.
The cool, calm demeanor of Avery Bradley, playing at his pace, creating space with the pull-up.
And another one falls.
The good times keep rolling, now tied for second all-time in scoring for a game.
Well, you know, the way he's been able to maintain his focus on offense all game, GA, the defense throws everything at him, but he still is scoring. He got it again. Sensational.
And that score moves him up in the record books yet again.
He now stands, Greg, alone for second place for points. What an unbelievable night.
To think that he has eclipsed Kobe's mark of 81 and now has his sights set on 100, this is a game you'll be talking about for decades.
To the inside, and it's sent back by Aldridge.
Great effort there. Aldridge sniffs out the shot, sends it back.
And we may have an injury here that does not look good.
Well, I mean, you really feel for him. I mean, and the entire team. Just, you got to hope for the best.
I just hate seeing this, but no need to jump the gun. Let's see what it turns out to be.
Spurs making a switch here. White's checked in. And the Clippers making a switch here. Scott's checked in. And we get a moment to check out the team scoring leaders. Fifth, the Clippers.
And how about the year they've had offensively? This is a team that can put points on the board in a hurry. Always fun to watch them play.
And so Aldridge will bring it up for the San Antonio Spurs. They'll be playing host to Chicago for their next game.
And really keeping the ball hopping around here offensively.
The Clippers have gone at a pretty good shooting pace. They're 6-13 from the field here in the third. Stolen by Gay. 3-on-3. Gets it to go for bucket number 8. He's taken just 10 shots.
And you couldn't have scripted a better start to the half. They've hit every single shot since the break.
Gay comes over with a double team. Kicks to Gallinari. Another possession, another assist. Dishing it all over the place in this one.
He's tallying them up in bunches.
Some people see Popovich as uncompromising. He can be that way. But working things out with LaMarcus Aldridge last year, just another great coaching achievement.
Knocked loose. Here is Cunningham. Lays it up off the glass. Cunningham's got 6 points.
Up by a bunch. He's still pushing the action, trying to impose his will.
With this big of a deficit in the score, you'd think the losing team would be playing harder. Nope, the opposite.
And with that Aldridge situation, Popovich said he was the first player to ever bluntly ask him for a trade.
And Popovich replied, Kevin, I'll be happy to trade you. You get me a talent like Kevin Durant, I'll drive you to the airport. Later, Pop says he was over-coaching Aldridge on the offensive end and took care of it.
And Aldridge, the basket on the assist by Rudy Gay. And that's 15 points for Aldridge.
Nice pass here to set that basket up.
And Aldridge comes over to help. Here's Gortat, and Gortat with the stuff.
Serve and the defense there. He makes a terrific read.
And the Spurs with possession. They're on a 16-6 run.
And he throws it right out of bounds. Careless mistake.
And some changes here for the Spurs. Pirtle, he's checked in for Cunningham. And it's Bellinelli in for Bryn Forbes. And then for Los Angeles, Montrezl Harrell, he's checked in for Gortat. And it's Patrick Beverley in for Gilgeous Alexander. Passes it to Beverley. Shoots a three. A rebound by the Spurs. Aldridge has got the glass covered here tonight. 11 boards for him. And Aldridge slams it in.
In the zone, boy. Aldridge making it look easy.
L.A. has gotten one of 6 3-pointers to drop since coming out of the locker room at halftime. And stolen by Aldridge. By himself. And the dunk by Aldridge.
Whoa, quick hands on the steal and then just mad hops on the slam.
Great sequence for them defensively and offensively.
Terrific defensive instincts to come away with that one, and he showed no hesitation in how he completed that transition opportunity.
Poked away, and it's out of bounds. Last touch by Aldridge. And a look now at the San Antonio Spurs' upcoming schedule. On Saturday, they'll defend home court against the Chicago Bulls. Then on Monday, they'll be facing Joel Embiid and the Philadelphia 76ers.
And no secret that this team can be very tough in their own building. And that's good news as they are loaded up with home games over the next stretch. This is a chance to create some separation. Rare you'll see him miss such an open look.
And it's time for an injury report. Now an update on DeMar DeRozan from David Aldridge. Dave, what'd you find out?
Hey, Kevin, I chatted briefly with the head athletic trainer for San Antonio. He told me that in his opinion, the injury does not appear to be too serious. And if he were to be out with an injury now, it would really hurt this team, Kevin, because they count on him to do so many things.
Thanks for checking in, DA. Injuries are always tough to deal with, but they're just a fact of life in the NBA.
And he'll have a lot of support as he goes through the recovery process. They want him back as soon as possible.
And we know how much better they'll be as a team when he's out of those street clothes and back in uniform.
Outside, Scott misses the three. Scott's gone 2 for 7, struggling a bit. To the paint, here's White, and White with the stuff.
Great scores like Aldridge. D plays him to shoot. He locates the open man. Easy doing.
The Clippers shooting 48% from the field as a team in this third quarter. And Beverly kicks to Bradley. The pass to Scott. Now Beverly, 8 points for him. Lets it go from 11. Here's Harrell, and there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time.
Fantastic positioning on that offensive board. Then right back up.
Here's Aldridge, and he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time, the whistle blowing. And the foul called on the Los Angeles Clippers.
Showing explosiveness that time. Aldridge, a better athlete than some people credit him for.
And this is his third trip to the line tonight.
LaMarcus Aldridge. At the line for two.
First free throw is good.
And if they continue, Kevin, their outstanding free throw shooting, that'll help them seal the deal.
Bertinus, he's checked in for San Antonio. Mills comes in for White. Marjanovic checked in for Los Angeles. Sendarius Thornwell comes in for Bradley.
Down and up that time, big time.
Big time, man.
Big time.
Hey, hey.
Big time.
Big time,
man. With a bathing ape camo suit. I'm not trying to flex, but I'm still fly.
Hey, do your thing. Be like Nephi, what up? You getting money? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You keeping lit? Oh, yeah.
And here is the shot chart as we see how things are going for DeRozan.
And this is the kind of performance that everyone talks about seeing in person. The way he's attacked the defense with no hesitation, the tough shots he's taken and made, just a masterpiece. When he gets it going, he can put up some big numbers.
Big time.
Both free throws good from Aldridge. And here's Beverly. He brings it up for the Clippers. And stolen by Aldridge. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
He can beat you from long range, mid range. That time, Aldridge draws the foul inside.
At the line for two.
And that one falls for LaMarcus Aldridge. And so he's able to get one of two. Steve, the NBA playing games in foreign countries now during the regular season. You think that'll become a more common occurrence?
I do, Kevin. I think they do a good job of getting a chance to, I would say, gather all the fans around the globe. Our game is going more global. And I think some of the players and some of the teams, they love it. I think a lot of times if they make sure the NBA, they're not sending the exact same teams and get a chance to spread the wealth, I think it's a great idea.
And here's Mills for three. Score that one for him. His eighth field goal. 8 for 11 on a very accurate night.
The former second rounder, Patty Mills, first made it in this league because of the deep range.
Marjanovic kicks to Beverly. And he can't answer back. The three-pointer offline. Aldridge down low. Harrell on him. Aldridge can't get it to go. Mills passes to Pirtle. Shoots it. Bertans can't get it to go.
And this is one of those times where the coach has got to preach, be unselfish.
And we don't know that he hasn't. Maybe it's been falling on deaf ears. Guys taking ill-advised jump shots.
And when he gets the ball that deep, not much you can do to stop him.
He knows what he's good at, gets the position he wants, then with the tools to finish.
Yep, that one goes in there. 26 points for LaMarcus Aldridge.
Making it look easy, the fluid shot mechanics of LaMarcus.
Here's Gallinari, and he finishes it off with a one-handed jam.
And this is the value of letting the play develop. You find the weakness in the defense.
Here's Aldridge. Here's Pirtle. Lays it in without an inch of room around him. Pirtle's got six.
Got to be on the lookout for Pirtle crashing the glass, using his body to wreck the defense on the boards.
Beverly finds Marjanovic, and Marjanovic with the slam.
And guys, he's not an easy man to stop when he's got the rim in his sights.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher.
And he is really in a zone right now, playing and scoring with confidence.
And Aldridge comes over to help, feeds it to Gallinari. It's a nice passing here by Los Angeles. Here's Thornwell. Bellinelli is covering. Basket counts. And that's 21 points for Gallinari.
Oh, great production on the interior right now. 8 straight from inside.
The shot and game clock separated by 4. That one good for 2. 30 points for LaMarcus Aldridge.
Didn't have any problem knocking that one down. Another defensive lapse leading to 2 more.
In the corner, Marjanovic with it. He feeds it to Gallinari. Count that one. Gallinari's got 23.
So much of his offense is perimeter-oriented. Good to see Gallinari attack inside.
Aldridge misses in close. It could go. The shot off that time. And so it's the San Antonio Spurs enjoying the kind of gigantic lead you almost never see. The scoring has been tremendous, and they are shooting lights out with very high accuracy. Back right after this. Now let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
Yeah, a terrific, unselfish play right here. Set up his teammate, and how about the setup this was?
At his position, traditionally, his job is to shoot the basketball. Give him credit for keeping his eyes up and just taking what the defense allows.
And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. And on the floor for the Clippers here in the fourth, Patrick Beverley out there with Robinson. Then there's Marjanovic. Then there's Gallinari. And it's Thornwell in at the small forward. And here's Beverley. He brings it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. Gallinari on the wing. Down low. Rejected by Walker, and he's able to get it back. And so it's San Antonio with it. And Aldridge, the basket on the assist by Pondexter. That's now 32 points for Aldridge.
This is his wheelhouse. LaMarcus Aldridge, unstoppable from mid-range.
To the inside. And that one's good, Marjanovic.
Nicely done. They continue to attack inside, and that's 10 points in a row in the paint.
Walker, and he uses the glass on the layup.
Perfect vision. Mills getting quicker these days at spotting the open man.
And down it goes. Dunked through off a wonderful assist.
That is ferocious.
You said it. That was ferocious. Wasted no time on that one. 34 points for Aldridge.
In the mid-range, rarely the hallmark of efficiency in today's NBA, but it is on point tonight.
And that one's good, Marjanovic.
Making a dent in this deficit. He's been on point tonight.
And really the story of the half, one team shooting it lights out, the other, the lights are just out.
You know what is two competing philosophies? One team playing it close to the vest, the other fast and loose.
Beverley with the ball. The teardrop falls in.
You see the quickness of Beverley. Blinding speed in the inside.
The drive by Aldridge. And the dunk by Aldridge.
He has really come into this second half on an absolute tear. Really impressive effort from him so far.
And we're around 2 minutes into the fourth quarter here. Robinson kicks to Marjanovic. And that one's good. Beverley. Beverly's got 4 points now in the quarter.
That was just a perfect possession, getting it in tight for the high percentage shot.
San Antonio calls timeout. You know, Patrick Beverley, first team all defense, Smitty back in 2017. He gets right in your chest. He is a tenacious defender.
He's hard-nosed. He's fearless, not just in your jersey. He wants to get under your skin.
Medu, he's checked in for LaMarcus Aldridge. Gortat's checked in for the Clippers. Teodosic comes in for Patrick Beverley. So it's San Antonio now. Pass to Medu. The shot from the low post is good.
Well, this is what every coach emphasizes. Keep your head up. Be willing to make the extra pass.
Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Robinson kicks to Teodosic. Marjanovic.
And you have to like the location of this pass. Gives it to him where he can do something with it.
For San Antonio, they've gone 7 of 7 from the field to start the final quarter. What an amazing start. And the basket is good. Got it to go through on the contact, so a free throw coming up. A great opportunity for a three-point play.
First personal foul.
When we look, Steve, at big stats like double-doubles, triple-doubles, are we becoming too enamored with that versus how it might affect winning?
No, I think we're always going to have those double-doubles and triple-doubles. I just think right now when you look at it, so many more possessions in games. That's why we're having guys average a triple-double or having more double-doubles. But he also gives those guys credit. The game and those players, they're just better right now, and they're more equipped to be versatile. But I do think we still got to keep the emphasis on winning. When a guy can get a triple-double in wins versus in losses or double-doubles or any kind of stats, I think that should be a category of his own.
Robinson drives in, up and in on the layup.
And when he gets in his head that he's going to get to the basket, very little you can do defensively.
There's Walker with the three. Rebound by the Clippers. Robinson down low. Guarded by Walker. Robinson, that's good. Robinson's got four this quarter. And out of bounds as the Clippers gain possession.
I mean, clearly not on the same page right there. You hate to give away possessions.
Scotty's checked in for Gortat. For Los Angeles, they've gone 8 of 10 from the field here in the fourth quarter. Really getting it done. Teodosic, the pass to Robinson. Back to Teodosic. And it's blocked. Stolen by Robinson. We've played just over 3.5 minutes now in the fourth quarter. There's the three. And that one's good, Teodosic.
Further proof that you can't leave anyone in this league that wide open.
And here's Mills for three. It's good from long range. Mills has got 23 points.
Not shy from outside. There's no doubt about that. Spreading the floor and getting them up.
Pass to Marjanovic. Good ball movement here by the Clippers. And that one's good, Teodosic.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Walker's shot is off.
He got a good look from the mid-range area. He needs to shoot this one with more confidence.
Teodosic kicks to Robinson. The jump shot from the baseline is right on target.
Assisted by Milos Teodosic.
And so it's Mills who will bring it up for San Antonio. And the rejection by Marjanovic. Passes it to Thornwell. And a great assist by Teodosic as that one goes in. Teodosic has got 3 assists now in this one. Robinson with the block. Steve, more and more we're seeing NBA players speak out on societal issues. Do you think it's gone too far in any way, or do you think it should go even farther?
No, I think players should speak up. I think in all, you know, our four major sports, in any possible way, I think guys should get a chance to weigh in on what they feel individually. Freedom of speech, and I think our players is just like everybody else. You have freedom of speech, you should be allowed to speak up on issues.
To the paint. Here's Thornwell. That shot, no good. And it's the Spurs taking it the other way. Here's Walker. The layup off target.
How is it possible? Wide open, too.
And Robinson wide open. He shoots. And that one hits back iron. San Antonio's gone 3 of 6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. Good work there as it goes. Walker's got 7 points here in this quarter.
And when you can outscore your opponent in transition, that's always going to work to your advantage.
The reason why a number of guys on this roster, they are built for speed. Why not play to your strengths?
San Antonio's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Here's Mills. And the layup's good off the glass. Mills has got 25 points.
One of the smallest men on the floor, Mills using his quickness against good interior defense.
Here's Teodosic. Los Angeles with another miss.
All the time in the world to get that one off.
An amazing finish with a hand right in his face.
And it's been about that execution offensively. I mean, they have been superb.
That's what's extending this lead. The right plays, right time, and good finishing. He really looks composed shooting the ball this half. Much more consistent, hitting a much higher percentage.
And the shot goes down.
Attacking the defense with the pass. Love the unselfishness.
And Los Angeles guys shooting 52% from the floor. Nice work so far from them. Now, here is Robinson. The pass to Thornwell. And he drops it in from the low post.
Ever since halftime, he's had his eyes on the basket and just crushing it right now.
A nice shot by Pondexter. Pondexter's got 8 here in the quarter.
Oh, great ball movement there.
Pondexter's gone 4-for-5 from the floor tonight. Just one miss. Teodosic, the pass to Marjanovic. Here's Teodosic to the middle. And the shot goes in from Thornwell.
He has flat-out dominated this quarter, hitting shots at will. Yet they still find themselves behind.
And out of bounds as the Clippers gain possession.
Ah, and right there, a little miscommunication on that pass.
A different look now for San Antonio. Dante Cunningham's checked in for Davis Bertans. Bellinelli comes in for Quincy Pondexter. And it's wide in for Patty Mills. And Los Angeles making a change here as well. Harrell's checked in. We know a lot of NBA players take how they've been rated in a video game, Steve, personally. You've made digital appearances during your career. Did you ever have any issues with the ratings?
No, I didn't. I think now these players, I grew up in this generation with video games, so yes, they take it personally. They understand,
yes,
and
they're
playing these games while they're in the NBA. So a lot of them, just like when the media is all over them, they want to have a say-so on how good they are, even in a video game.
You gotta love his aggressiveness to finish inside.
Well, his leaping ability gives him a great advantage. It's good.
Yeah, and Bellinelli, very creative, has that ability to get into the heart of the defense.
Teodosic kicks to Harrell. Here's Thornwell. Goes back up. Got a hand on it. Here's Bellinelli. Terrific assist, a nice finish, solid play all around.
And on the defensive side, just a failure to match up.
Well, the one thing you want to take away is anything at the rim. Just too easy. Sharing the basketball, plenty of guys talk about it, but not everyone does it.
Lets it go from the wing, and it's San Antonio with another.
I mean, even he was surprised to be that open.
L.A. has gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. Teodosic kicks to Robinson. Here's Thornwell. And he buries that one, drilling the rim on the way down. San Antonio's gone 3-6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. Count that bucket.
Really nice work. Hurdle going to town on the weak defense down in the paint.
The Clippers shooting 53% from the floor. They're locked in. Inside, Harrell, and Harrell slams it in.
Explosive leaping ability allows him to play the five, even though he's a little undersized.
Goes up the baseline. Good for the fifth time in 5 shots. He remains perfect.
Textbook form from Pirtle, getting room to shoot from the mid-range and nailing the shot.
To the inside, Harrell, that's good. Harrell's got 6 points in the quarter.
He has to show real leadership out there and take this game into his own hands because he's shooting the ball well.
The shot by Bellinelli, no good.
One could argue that's a good shot, but maybe not the right shooter to take it.
Here's Thornwell. Bellinelli is covering. Pass to Teodosic. Walker against Robinson. Clock at six. Teodosic, no good. And it's Walker with the ball, bringing it up for San Antonio.
And one team is just completely outclassing the other tonight. Spirited performance, and it really ignited what is turning out to be a monster win here for San Antonio.
As one-sided as it gets today, you know, there were some dominant moments in about every facet of this game for that team.
Yeah, I mean, Kevin, it's hard to think of what didn't go right for them. Game planning by the coaches, execution by the players, everything was just on target.
And so this will mark the 15th win of the year for them.
And they're able to even the score of this series at a game apiece still. Two more to go in the season series.
The one player that really stands out, of course, in this one, it was a dazzling game for DeMar DeRozan.
You know what stood out to me was the anticipation defensively. He sensed what the offense wanted to run, then found ways to disrupt that and cause turnovers.
And they've earned this one, showing an ability to dominate in front of their home crowd.
You know, you feel on top of the world when it happens as a player, just the relationship you have with the fans. I like to see that, taking it up strong in traffic.
And here's a timeout from Greg Popovich. Guys, what do you think?
Now, you know, I'm not sure why you call a timeout this late. I mean, the game is more or less over.
I'm not questioning that either, but he clearly hasn't given up on this one quite yet.
Present our Jordan Player of the Game, DeMar DeRozan.
And Kevin, it's a no-brainer. He's controlled every aspect of this game, and it's just so fun to see a player perform at a level that's just higher than anyone else out on the floor.
The better he played, the more these fans got revved up, and that continued to play out over the course of his amazing performance. Pondexter kicks to Cunningham. Over Harrell. Cunningham gets the bucket.
And just putting the finishing touches on this one, they have been on fire.
I mean, a fantastic run. The guys are really clicking, and the scoreboard reflects that.
And this run may make the score look a little more acceptable, but still a loss.
They could never put it together when it mattered. Just let too many opportunities slip through their fingers.
At the line for your Spurs, Marco Bellinelli. At the line for two.
And the first one drops. San Antonio calls timeout. They're up. 7 seconds left to play in the final quarter. What do you think, guys?
Now, you know, I'm not sure why you call a timeout this late. I mean, the game is more or less over.
I'm not questioning that either, but he clearly hasn't given up on this one quite yet.
Don't pick up the phone. most evidence. Say my name out of self-defense. Catch me on stage with B-Real off to a bend. You all was famous. We got that call themselves Band-Aids to keep their feelings painless. Nothing to lose, got only game this year. Out of control, cause me 6 years. Flow for my peeps and peers. You know we taking live on stage.
He's off on the second. And so it's San Antonio, easily taking this one. It was a tale of two teams tonight, one that was in total control, operating flawlessly, and the other just searching for answers that they could never find.
I mean, the energy here is just so tremendous. Fans involved from the get-go, and once they started to really pour it on, it was fun to see that rhythm and flow from their perspective.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks very much. LaMarcus, your game has evolved. Started as a finesse player, and now you have a lot more inside aggression. How did you get more comfortable down low?
Just takes time, you know. I got stronger every year, got better every year. You know, when I was younger, I wasn't strong, but now I'm much stronger, I'm much older now.
And a veteran who gets it done. Thank you, LaMarcus. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. So long.